What's up? It's me, it's Queen on Set Haru, and we have three winners. Now, you guys remember, we had 10,000 subscribers and I did a giveaway. I finally have three winners. So now I'm going to announce my three winners. Now, if you hear your name, please email me so we can make an appointment for your free 60-minute reading, okay? So my first winner is Luz Lopez. Luz, hit me up, girlfriend. My second winner is Princess of Healing. I talked to her on Instagram. And my third winner is Team Broccoli, also Instagram. So you guys can email me at askanaquarius007 at gmail.com, or you can hit me up on social media, Instagram or Twitter or Facebook, you know, whatever way you feel more comfortable using. And if you don't remember my email, it's always underneath this video along with my social media. Okay, so congratulations and hit me up. I'm gonna hook you up. All right, guys. So today we're going to talk about the futuristic Aquarius. Someone said to me that they heard that Aquarius are futuristic, and we are very much so. So I want to tell you a little bit about that and see how many of you have had this experience yourself as an Aquarius or with an Aquarius. So those of you who do not know, I am Queen Orset Haru, and thank you for joining me for today's edition of Ask an Aquarius. If you haven't already, please hit the red subscribe button and smack the bell. Also, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, pass it on to somebody else who might like it too, and leave us a positive comment in the comment section, because after every video, if you stick around to the end, I read out two of my favorite comments, and one of those positive comments could be one of your comments. If you're a new subscriber, I would like to welcome you. I saw a bunch of new people come in. I was like, yo, what's up? And to all of my old subscribers, thank you for continuing to support Ask an Aquarius. So now let's get into today's topic. Aquarius are very futuristic, and it's really weird, you know, because Aquarius are futuristic, but on the other hand, a lot of us are old-fashioned, and you don't usually see that combination. Most people who are futuristic have the tendency to throw away the past, to think that everything from the past is old and outdated and out of time and out of touch. And they're pushing towards the new technology, the new thing, the new it thing, you know? And one thing about Aquarius is we manage in some kind of strange way to balance both of those things simultaneously. Aquarius have a lot of contradictions. I've told you guys this many times. We're two things at once very often. So in this case, we're futuristic, and we're also, a lot of us are very old fashioned. And how do we, like, I'm gonna tell you how we balance this, and then I'm gonna explain a little bit more about it. The way that we're able to balance this is that we keep the stuff from the past that's good, the stuff that works. Like, if you listen to me talk, one of the things I believe very strongly is that we should go back to the old fashioned ways of dating. I think the long courting process helped a lot of people have stronger, better relationships. Now, some of those relationships still had problems. Some of them still broke up. But if you look at it as a collective, look at the time period when people had to put more effort into getting their lover. When there was more effort being put into it, the relationships lasted longer and a lot of times were better relationships. If it took you years to get the person that you wanted to be with you, a lot of times you were, I'm sure, a lot more appreciative when you finally got this person. So I believe that. I believe that strongly. But at the same time, there are things from the past that didn't work, such as, enslavement was part of the past, and it definitely didn't work for a large portion of us. So some things from the past did not work. So Aquarius throw all the things that don't work away, but is willing to keep the things that do work. And we're also, in some cases, able to fix some of the things. Aquarius are inventors. So we might be able to take something from the past that didn't work and fix it, tweak it, and make it work differently and better now. And then at the same time, we're futuristic because we're always inventing something. We're always making up something new. So a lot of people, you know, they are like, wow, where did you get that? Where did you find that style? Where did you get that poem? Where did you get that song? And a lot of times the Aquarius made it up, you know, a lot of times it is our creativity. So that's really cool. And inventions. I have a lot of famous Aquarius on our list who are inventors. So we make gadgets and we make things, we make all kinds of things as needed in most cases. Because someone asked me once, how do Aquarius decide on these futuristic things to make? And a lot of times it's just as needed. A lot of inventions are like that. I think they say necessity is the mother of invention. Well, with an Aquarius, when we need something, we invent something if something isn't already available. So this is very helpful to us and to other people who are able to utilize whatever that thing is as well. So yeah, we have a tendency to invent things as we need them. All kinds of people on my list are inventors and scientists and all kinds of things like that who are Aquarius. So it's very common for us to be looking to the next technology, the next thing, or how to improve something that we currently have. That is very Aquarius. And when I talked about us having a duality, I talked about us having one foot, a lot of us being old fashioned and a lot of us being simultaneously futuristic. I think some people have a hard time balancing those two things, but you don't have to do one or the other. You can do both. You can like old fashioned things even, you know. I love oil lanterns. Old-fashioned oil lanterns that you put oil in and you set the thing on fire and put the glass thing on top. I have several of them in storage. They're often used in magic. That's how I learned about them and started using them. But I really love them. I love the light that they give. They give this beautiful glow. I'm not sure. I think it depends on the kind of oil that you use, if it's healthier or not. I think that is a big consideration. I think that's also why a lot of people stop using them. But they are really beautiful. They have a beautiful glow and I really like them. So like I said before, we have a tendency to like a lot of like old things. I like old Hollywood. I wear a lot of styles and I create a lot of things from watching old movies, you know? But at the same time, I'm quick to make something up. So you don't have to be stuck in the past or perpetually racing towards the future. You know, you can have a nice little happy medium. I think that one of my biggest things is I need to get more with the present. And I don't know if Aquarius always do well with the present. We do well with the other two, but the present is the one that can sometimes be a little bit more challenging. So yeah, we are very futuristic in those kinds of ways. And we're quick to be early adopters. I know a lot of Aquarius who always have the latest gadgets, you know, the latest new phone, the latest iPad, the latest TV, the latest new camera. A good friend of mine, she's into makeup. She always has the latest trend in makeup. You know, she's Aquarius, and every time I talk to her, she's telling me the newest thing that has come out, the waterproof, or, you know, something like that. So a lot of Aquarius I know, no matter what the industry is, even if it's music or something else, they know all the latest things, the newest things. They know things before they happen. You know, like I often know things that are going to come out, you know, before other people do. Like, for instance, if it's one of my interests, like Harry Potter, for example, I often know what's going to come out before it comes out. You know, if there's a new doll coming out, if there's a new, you know, sheet set coming out, because I like Harry Potter merch. So I have a tendency to be on sites that tell us what's getting ready to come out. Curtains, there's a whole bunch of stuff that just recently came out. The Harry Potter franchise is constantly creating new stuff, either merchandise from the franchise itself or other people making things based off of the franchise. And I hear about them all the time because I'm plugged into groups that love Harry Potter. So I always know about things before they even happen. And people are like, how did you even know that was going to happen? And I'm like, oh, I'm on this group, I'm on that group. So we're very into that concept of knowing before things happen. And also a lot of us on a spiritual type tip, a lot of us have prophecy. So we often see things. We see things before they happen, either in our dreams or a vision, or we just know, like, so-and-so is going to happen, and we just know it's going to happen. I remember a long time ago in like it was like the beginning of the 2000s. I had a dream, and I woke up from this dream. I had this dream that all the people I knew in the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, questioning, IA community were there. They were all in this room. It was a big room, and we were celebrating. And when I woke up, I said, we're going to get our rights. A couple years later, gay people won the right to get married in the United States. And then it started happening in other countries too. And I was like, I knew it, you know? And it was just because in that dream, I saw it. And it wasn't just like, you know, some dreams are just dreams. You know, I don't know what those are. They're just kind of kooky. They don't really have much of a foundation to them. And some that I have are prophecies, and some are things that actually happen. And that dream, I knew it. When I woke up, I said it out loud, and somebody had called me on the phone, and that's how I woke up. And I said, we're going to get our rights. And they were like, what? What are you talking about? And I'm like, yo, we're going to get them. And like, how you know? I saw it. So we also have a tendency to see the future in that kind of way too. So yeah, we're very futuristic in that way. It's a good thing though. I like knowing things before they actually occur. I don't always tell people though. I tell people the stuff that is important, or the stuff that, you know, if something needs to be done about it. Like, you know, I'll tell them that stuff. You know, a friend of mine, you know, she was really, really sick, and I let her know, like, you need to handle this because this is not going to go well. You know, the cards were telling me she wasn't going to make it is the bottom line. She was going to check out. And I told her, I said, you know, and that's not something I would normally say to a person, especially if it's nothing they can do about it. If I saw that, I wouldn't tell somebody that. That's kind of screwed up. But I knew in her case, she could change it. So I went and told her, and she's alive today. Thank God. So now I'm going to do two of my favorite positive comments. The first one is from Miss Aquarius Tarot. Hello, Miss Aquarius Tarot. And let's see what she says. From my childhood till this day, my dream was living alone in the woods, in my cozy cabin with my fireplace, my books, and my self-made potions. That sounds so wonderful. Far away from people. I was like, what's wrong with me? And then I remembered, oh, I'm Aquarius. Love you, Queen. What a beautiful spirit. Hey, sweetie, love you too. And I agree with you 100%. That does sound nice. I really feel you. Sometimes I'll see these memes on Facebook, and it'll be like a cabin surrounded by woods or surrounded by water or something. And then it'll say something like, could you stay here with no Wi-Fi and no other person for a year by yourself? And I'm looking like, easy. A year, easy. If I had the things that I love with me, my books, my potions, my cards, you know, my music, if I had the things that I love, my rum, if I had the things with me that I really love, easy, easy, no questions asked. And you get $1 million for doing it? Of course. Moody Blues Bulletin Board. Cool. That's a cool name. Moody Blues Bulletin Board said, I'm a Sagittarius with Venus in Scorpio, and my energy manifests the same way. Mad respect for Aquarius. I relate to them so well. You know, I have an Aquarius moon, and I always tell people that I have a Sagittarius moon, and I always tell people that Sagittarius and Aquarius have a very similar energy to me. Like the intellectual part is very similar. The wanderlust is very similar. There are certain parts about us that are very similar. Sagittarius have, you know, some, of course, their own special nuances, but I do see a lot of similarities. So thank you so much for your comment. All right, guys, if you want to get a reading done, please email me. If you would like to send me a gift, my Amazon wish list is underneath this video. If you would like to send a donation to Ask an Aquarius, my PayPal is underneath this video. And if you want to be one of my patrons and check out my new series, Magical Minutes, please check out the link underneath this video to become a patron. All right, guys, come back soon because I got a lot more to say. See you later.